What is up, hackers? Welcome back to another episode of Hack Crypto. We hack all of our crypto education. If you guys are brand new here, be sure to be subscribed with the notification bell on and like this video, gets it out to more people. Now, in this episode, I'm going to be going over a full demo of Arch, the lending platform that allows you to borrow against crypto assets, specifically Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Solana. What I love about Arch is that it is simple to use, very similar to BlockFi, where it has a great design, it's very intuitive, easy to go on, easy to understand. Everything is laid out in simple terms. And when it comes to financial instruments, it's very important to understand all the different aspects of what you're getting into. And when it comes to 60% loan to value ratios, when it comes to partial liquidations, when it comes to margin calls and the different fluctuations that you're gonna have in the underlying asset that you're borrowing against, it's very important. When things are volatile, like a crypto asset, like Ethereum or Bitcoin, you need to understand what's going into this. So I like how they've laid it out. I'm gonna show you guys the sign up all the way to the actual loan itself. And my favorite part of this is the explanation screen because it's very easily laid out and the different ways that you can play with the loan numbers on the screen before you move forward. So there's a lot of interesting parts here. It's very important to know upfront that when you're doing a loan like this, it is for personal use. The individual use is different than the business use. And that is banking rules, that is regulation. There's a lot of things that go into that. So everybody that's looking at this and is going to sign up for this, it's important to know if you take a loan out and you're an individual, do that with a personal bank account. If you are a business, you would have to go through the institutional selection on their platform that is different. So it is a different process. So the previous video I did on Arch was because they had just raised $75 million in a mix of equity and of course debts to accelerate the lending aspect of this with collateralized loans. But ultimately people have asked me since I put that video out and I've talked about a lot of these different products over the years, why would you do this? Why would you do a 15% short-term 12-month loan on something like Bitcoin or Ethereum? A couple different things. What's really important to know is that this is not a taxable event. This is debt. You are borrowing against an asset that you own and you are taking a debt note against that asset. So therefore, that's not a taxable event. That is in and of itself an extreme value. If you liquidate an asset, you no longer own it and you have that cash, but you owe tax on that transaction. This is not that type of transaction. This is debt against that asset. You are unlocking liquidity where it was not there previously. Now, the tax after you are doing a sale of something like one Bitcoin, you're going to be paying 20% or so. It depends on how long you held it, but ultimately in rough numbers, you're going to pay 20%. So if you knock that off, that's an 80% LTV if you were to borrow against that. This is offering 60% loan to value. So I think it's important to weigh these up when you're thinking about different options out there. And Arch is very legitimate in the US. Super secure. So another question that I've gotten is like, okay, well, my credit's not good. What do I do? This does not require a credit check by any means. You do have to verify your identity just because of the Patriot Act and different things in the United States, but you do not have to do a credit check. It's just going to verify your identity and it does it within the same day. You can get your funds. It's up to 12 months, 14-15% interest rate, depending on the LTV. And what is really key here to understand when you're borrowing at 14 or 15%, what's crucial is what you're doing with that money has to offset that percentage. And I'll say that in a different way. If you're borrowing against an asset that has a 15% cost of capital on it, you need to make sure that what you are putting that money into is greater than that cost of capital, like an investment in a business that has no cap into what you can return. There are a couple different options that I'm going to talk about in here, like interest only versus the principal and interest. There's two different levers here. Interest only usually implies that you're going to restructure it or refinance it before the 12 months is up. This is how hard money lending works usually in like real estate. And then you have the principal and interest. That means you're actually chipping away at the debt. Now, a very important behind the scenes look here is most lenders and most businesses, and I can say this because I've been on the lending side before and I have had a business in that space. The origination fees are where people make money. Transaction fees are where people make money and in finance in general. So every time that 12-month term comes due and is about to expire, the restructuring is a fee. That is an additional fee where basically the originators are making money off of that. And it's important to know what those fees are. These are 1.5% origination fees. So if it's a 14% rate, you're looking at 15.5%. So whatever you're doing with that money needs to outpace that 15.5%, which likely is going to be starting a business or investing in your current business or consolidating debt, like a credit card, for example, that's at 25, 30% interest rate. Consolidating that down and chipping that in half is likely a good financial move, knowing that you're going to restructure this in the future, keeping in mind there is going to be a fee when you do restructure it. That's on the interest only side. The principal and interest side, that's when you're actually chipping away at that principal, making payments, and it's going down over time. And I have yet to see, you know, people that I know that are doing those types of payments, because their goal, if they can get interest only, is to do it because it's lower cost and they can figure it out in 12 months time to restructure it, and they can make their move that they want to do. And the odds are within a year, you can give yourself a year to make that percentage 15 and a half or greater on that money. Most of the time you're going to do it. Sometimes you won't. It's worth the risk, in my opinion, because you're not liquidating the asset itself and you're making your payments back. So no credit score or check required, instant qualifications for a minimum of $1,000, flexible payback at any time, so you can pay it off at any time that you want, because they have that origination fee on the front. That's where they make the money. And then the amortization and interest only, of course, are the two options that you can choose depending on what you're doing with those funds. Investments, large purchases, the day-to-day finances like consolidation and your debt consolidation on high interest debt like credit cards and stuff like that. It's really important that you know that these are non-taxable and that this is used by the wealthiest people in the world, these types of instruments. So I like that Arch is doing this, bringing it to the masses. People deserve to know about these products. And as long as you can understand what's going on with the actual fees and the structure of this, that's what I'm trying to do in this video and the previous video that I did. Just understand what's going on and use these as a tool. It is a tool. Debt is like a flame. It's like fire. You can cook with it. You can make all sorts of things happen with it. You can make tools out of it and everything, but it can also burn you and set your house on fire. So use the tools after you've learned everything there is to know about them. This is not a sponsored review by Arch. I've reached out and said, hey guys, I'm gonna be making a video, and they were like, awesome. And this is not a sponsored transaction by any means. I just wanted to use the platform. And now that I am a user of the platform, I'm stoked for what they're doing. I'm really excited for this. So let's jump on to their website and I'll show you end to end what this looks like. All right, guys, it is demo time. Now, there are four different phases of setting up a new loan on Arch. There's the first, which is configuration. This is where you're going to enter in all of the information that you need to structure your loan. So first, we're gonna go ahead and put our location in. This is Florida, and there is the payback period. So this can be anywhere under 12 months, basically. The maximum length that they have right now is 12 months. I believe that that could change over time, but ultimately they're starting with 12 months. Now, principal and interest. There are a lot of benefits and, of course, downsides to having principal and interest with a short-term loan, but ultimately the interest only is usually what people are going to pick, because you're going to refinance this or restructure it, however you want to phrase it. You're going to change the terms of this likely by the end of the 12 months or before the end of the 12 months. So if you want to chip away at the principal and interest, you can do so, but ultimately people are usually going to restructure it anyway. So interest only is usually the way to go. We're going to go ahead and put in one here, and you can see our terms, 15.5% APR, and that consists of 14% annual interest rate plus 1.5% origination fee annualized. This, at the time of recording this, $62,000 Bitcoin, is a loan amount of $37,000. And why is that less than the overall amount of Bitcoin, you ask? That is this number right here, loan to value. Now, loan to value is a ratio that is calculated. If you go back and check my videos that I've done in the past with collateralized loan platforms in the crypto space, the LTV ratio is similar to a HELOC or a HELOAN on a rental property or a real estate investment. So the idea here is that you are basically only allowed to take a certain percentage of that collateral out, and it is a balance for risk when it comes to the lender's perspective. But from the borrower's perspective, you just need to know what percentage you can take out. So they have their different calculations here, of course, and they're different by the asset. Very important to know that. This isn't 60% across the board. That is the max for Bitcoin specifically. And you can see that they have, you know, their different percentages, and you can see there is a liquidation that happens when the price moves around. And there are a lot of different terms going into this, but ultimately what you need to know is that the percentage here is the amount that you get towards the entire value. If it's worth 100,000 and it's a 60% LTV, you're going to be able to take out up to 60,000 worth of that currency. So the value and the loan is going to be 60% at 62,000, which is 37,333 at 15.5%. And that equals $435 per month with the origination fee, which is that 1.5% of the total loan amount at origination. And let's go ahead and see what happens when it's not interest only. What happens when you need to pay back and chip away at the principal with interest on top? You're looking at a $3,352 a month payment, and that origination fee doesn't change because it's on the overall loan amount. And this is a really crucial difference for people out there, depending on what you're trying to do. And I'll talk about this on later videos as to the reason that people will do these types of short-term loans with principal and interest versus just interest and vice versa. I think that it's really important to understand the differences in terms of what you're doing with the funds. Like, the reason that you're borrowing against an asset is likely to make an investment in a business or an investment in another asset of some kind. And you're likely going to be looking for double this or more, greater than this in some percentage. If you're borrowing at 15%, you need to be making more than that annually to make it make sense. Usually the only way that you're gonna make more than that is business. If you're going to borrow against an asset to start a business, it is a very, you know, some people will call it risky, but that is the best use of funds for something like this at this interest rate, because that's the only way that you're going to be able to get past that level of interest rate there. So that is the structure of the loan. We're gonna go ahead and reduce this down to 0.5 just to make things a little bit easier for people to digest. We'll do interest only, $217 a month. Origination fee is 280. And you can see the last payment is 1 month at 18,840. We're going to press continue. It's going to take us to the next stage here. This is a really important stage because it describes the margin call. Why is that important, you ask? It is the loan health. So you're going to be looking at the status of your loan throughout the process of repaying it. And the reason here is because when you're using collateral to borrow against, what you need to be very, very cautious of is what's called liquidation. And liquidation, if you're brand new to any sort of financial instruments, it means that there needs to be a rebalancing of the risk associated with what you are doing in a transaction like this. And when the numbers get a little wonky, when the underlying asset that you're borrowing against changes in value, you get a margin call. It's literally usually a phone call. In this case, it's all automated. So you get a phone call or an email or a message of some kind that says, hey, the LTV has pushed into a danger zone here. It's gotten into the orange zone, and we actually need to liquidate some of your asset. It's called a partial liquidation. We need to liquidate some of this to rebalance the risk here. We need to recalibrate this LTV so that it makes sense, everybody's comfortable with it, and we're gonna do that. And this is when you're agreeing to the collateralized loans, you are agreeing to partial liquidations and margin calls and when you get notifications. So here is the example, guys. At this loan of a half a Bitcoin at 18,666, at a 65% LTV, you're gonna get a notification. That says that Bitcoin has dropped to 57,000 from where it is today at 62,000. So roughly a 5K drop. If it goes down, you are at a 65%. You've jumped up from 60 to 65% LTV. And you get a notification that says, whoa, hey guys, volatility is going on here. We're gonna monitor the situation, but a margin call comes at 70%. And then boom, Bitcoin drops even further from 62,000 down to 53,000. So 9,000 down, almost 10,000 down. And you're sweating a little bit, you get a phone call and it says, hey, this is now 70% LTV. We are going to need to get more collateral from you deposited into your account so that we can get back to a healthy range for the loan and get back to that 60% LTV ratio that we started with. Now the scorched earth situation happens. It drops from 62,000 to 46,000. Boom, it just market collapse, an FTX situation happens. Feels like the world's melting down, but ultimately they're going to liquidate part of that collateral to recalibrate it for you. There's not really a conversation that is, hey, we need to get more collateral from you. We're taking the collateral that we have on hand and liquidating pieces of that to make sure that we are rebalanced here back to the 60% that we started with. So these are the three stages. You get a notification at 57, which is a 65% LTV. You get a margin call at 70% LTV, which is 53,000 here. And then you get a partial liquidation of the collateral itself, in this case, Bitcoin, at 80% LTV. So these are very important to understand your different levels of loan health and the different ratios and everything that go into when that partial liquidation happens. Next up, we have how you want to get paid. Now, a big value to Arch and what BlockFi was doing for a while there before they got acquired and some of these other platforms out there that are doing collateralized loans like Unchained it's really important to figure out your tax implications, because this is a non-taxable event. When, if you were to sell half a Bitcoin here and take that money off the table, you would be paying tax on that. In a collateralized loan environment and that type of transaction, it's not taxable. That's debt. So that is a huge value to this, and you are sacrificing that in the LTV percentage, basically. So in order to hold on to the asset itself, you have to have that kind of lower LTV ratio, but you need to determine how you're going to get paid out. Is it going to stay in the crypto ecosystem in a stablecoin like USDC, or are you going to take it in dollars, in this case, US dollars, right into your bank account? And most cases, most of the people that I know that do these types of loans, they're doing it in dollars so they can make a business transaction in US dollars, and they're getting out of the ecosystem. And that is sort of the bridge here that people are trying to accomplish. They're trying to keep their digital assets while moving into cash positions and not having a tax liability set up here and making it a pretty seamless experience. So definitely, in my opinion, a bank wire. Personal loans require dispersal to personal bank accounts. It would likely be dispersed if you would like to put it into a business bank account. You will have to borrow using a business entity. So the thing here is that this is only for personal use, not business use. So you're going to have to do it as an individual. You know, you can do whatever you want with the funds after the fact, like invest in a business once it's taken out into your personal account. But that's a really key aspect here. They are, you know, regulated in the US, and making sure that institutions and entities that are businesses are signed up correctly as businesses are getting the proper wires sent. So that's really, really important. So you go ahead and add your account on there. You put your bank name, your routing number, all that, and get it all entered in. It is going to connect to your bank account directly and deposit those funds. So after all of this, you are going through a KYC process. You are getting your information all entered in here. You're confirming the loan terms once again. So you've set up the configuration on the front end, understood the levels of the LTV changes, the partial liquidations, the margin call levels that you need to know in the event of volatility. You verify your identity, you confirm the terms. And then of course, lastly, you send the collateral, and then bada bing, bada boom, you have the money in your bank account or your crypto wallet if you're staying in the ecosystem to make it crypto investments or other digital asset focused investments. But if you're trying to do a real estate transaction or fund your business or something like that in US dollars, this loan could be a very important detail for your business without having a tax implication there. So that is the four steps, guys. Very easy to do here. I mean, that is an understatement. I did this in a relatively quick amount of time, and I'm very pleased with the overall process. It's been pretty seamless, very similar design to BlockFi and some of the other lenders that I've gone through for transactions like this, but I'm very excited about what they've built here. This is the type of simplicity that we need for pretty complex instruments like this. And getting this to the masses is pretty crucial, having this available to people that are holding crypto, that don't want to liquidate it, and they want to make investments and continue using funds without all the implications that come with selling it. It is a really, really valuable tool here. That is it for my video on the crypto-backed loan platform, Arch Lending. I've done a few videos on these types of instruments, like your Unchained and BlockFi's that used to exist back in the day, Salt Lending and all of that. There's a lot of interesting players in the space, but I like seeing credible ones like this come up, because this is really, really crucial for people to understand how this works. People need to understand that this exists. They need to understand that they don't need to just liquidate assets every single time they want to make a move. They can borrow against them, make a great rate of return over here, and then come back, pay it off, and then repeat. And this is just a classic move for people in finance. So I'm glad that I can make this video for people, hoping to make one in the future. I'm glad that I'm a user of the platform. That is it for this episode, and I will see you here on the next episode of Hack Crypto.